the writings of Virginia Woolf, time is elastic or elastic, and half a sentence said by someone with so reminded of feeling the same intensity 20 years ago that you can transform people to a different time, transport them, and then even make them rise and hang on the horizon like 10 years ago on a terrace top in broad daylight. And it was awfully sweet to call out to still have the power. As she came tingling, hustling, still had the power as she came across the great moon, which she detested, rise and burden on the terrace in the summer sky, keeping Peter watch in Mrs. Dalloway. And so there is constant, I think that novel Mrs. Dalloway begins, the opening sentences, and Mrs. Dalloway says that she will buy the flowers herself. So there is a constant, I think, relationship established between her characters, be it in the novel to the White House where she's ready to see vacation, or be it in other places where she's talking about her entire previous theories or all its normal that she's part of the Bloomsbury group, which is not just feminist and liberal and very encouraging of the young writers, but also anti-imperialist in many ways. And so we mentioned a very strong political feelings as well. Conservation of nature at that point in time wasn't such a big rallying cry in England as it is today. But you can see the writer's love of nature and her closeness to it. We all know that Virginia Woolf herself was a troubled person to the extent, even though she was a phenomenal writer and there was a massive amount of research that exists on her. But you know that she was institutionalized and this was related to the tribal, the Bloomsbury step brothers, and the untimely death of both her parents after which she was institutionalized. But time and again, we see that she goes back to the metaphor of nature, to long paragraphs describing the seasons, it is the summer, what behavior reminds her of summer. You know, the old woman say that the wasn't so cold. That or the spine is so warm, feeling that I brought children into the world. So that way, the way she brings the metaphor of nature in the novels is just phenomenal to me, basically, that is what I am saying in a couple more sentences. As a cloud crosses the sun, silence falls from London and falls from the mind. So continuously, it is the nature that is to the psychological life of the group. And we know of the famous characters of the various characters, which number is suddenly the man that is back from the war, and we know that Woolf died in 1941, she gave herself writing an opportunity to the hospital, till then they died in certain time, and I began, but to me they found it more happy. And I think this is the moment to the J-War. 41 is also the time of the Second World War. And the depiction of this character, September, is very sort of emblematic of the horror that Europe also went through during the Second World War. Not just the colonies in India, but I think I am going to stop here. It doesn't take a lot of time, but that is a good point. mostly in terms of